What's up, guys? It's Blind Run, and today I have the Gigabyte Gaming G1 graphics card
1070.
Stick around. The Gigabyte GTX 1070 Gaming G1 features the WinForce 3 cooler, graced with an orange and black color scheme, which is odd as the card does feature an RGB lighting feature, which, once again as we've seen in the past, throws off your ability to customize your color scheme, like the MSI Gaming X Edition did with red. Display ports include 3 DisplayPort 1.4 ports, a single HDMI 2.0B port, and a single dual-link DVI. Next, we have the 8-pin power adapter sporting a 6+2 power phase, which is an upgrade from the Founders Edition at 4+1, but still falls short of the 8+2 power phase featured on MSI Gaming X Edition. However, the power draw is upped from the Founders Edition to the same level as we've seen on MSI's Gaming X. Under the hood, the card sports an advertised 1822 MHz boost clock, while in real world cases it boosts to 1962 MHz without even touching an overclocking tool. With a little tweaking, the card will overclock to 2050 MHz, and this boost clock communicates over a 256-bit bus with 8GB of GDDR5 at a clock of 8000 MHz. Or 8008 MHz if you want to be a real asshole like their website advertising. The cooling solution works great. If you are so inclined to crank the fans up to 100%, the fans reach 20 decibels over my ambient room noise, which is about 30 decibels. With stock fan profiles set, the card hit a max temperature of 67 degrees Celsius. So in this case, I would say you probably never need to crank those fans to any audible level. Let's talk numbers. As always, all benchmarks are going to be in 1080p at highest available settings, unless that setting is specific to either AMD or Nvidia, for example, Pure Hair. In Rise of the Tomb Raider, the Gigabyte GTX 1070 Gaming G1 hit 60.45 frames per second, falling short of the Gaming X Edition from MSI by a couple frames. In Forza Motorsport 6 Apex, which is still in beta, the Gigabyte GTX 1070 Gaming G1 hit 87.95 frames per second. As you guys may have seen in some of my earlier reviews, because this game is in beta, the optimizations are changing every day. So, it beating out the MSI version doesn't necessarily mean that it's doing better. In 3DMark TimeSpy Graphics Test 1, it scored 64.1 frames per second, which is right on par with the Gaming X Edition. In 3DMark TimeSpy Graphics Test 2, it scored 52.45 frames per second, once again, right on par with the MSI Gaming X Edition. However, things do start to change in real-world settings. With Doom in Vulcan, the Gigabyte version, or trim of this card, hit 178.25 frames per second, losing out by a couple frames to the MSI GTX 1070 version. In Gears of War Ultimate Edition, we see the same thing where it falls short of the MSI trim by a couple frames, coming in at 127.8 frames per second. And this also continues with Hitman coming in at 92 frames per second, falling short by almost 2 frames to the MSI trim of the same card. In Total War Warhammer, the Gigabyte received 62.2 frames per second, which is about on par with the MSI GTX 1070 Gaming X Edition. The reason for Total War being so close would probably be because the game is heavily CPU dependent, and as long as the cards are within the same ballpark at all, they're going to be scoring almost exactly the same. What I find interesting is that the synthetic benchmarks are almost directly on par, but once we transfer over into real-world scenarios, the Gigabyte GTX 1070 Gaming G1 loses out to the MSI GTX 1070 Gaming X Edition. This is probably due to the weaker power phases in the Gaming G1 version, which also shorted it on the overclock. In conclusion, while the Gigabyte Gaming G1 Edition has proven to outpace the Reference Design or Founders Edition, it still falls short of other third-party non-reference designs. However, it is cheaper than these other third-party non-reference designs that do beat it out. So, it's up to you where you want to put that $10 bill you're saving by picking this card up over the competition. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed yet another graphics card processing unit review from yours truly, Blind Run, here at Son of a Tech. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below, and I will see you next Tuesday.